Саша Михайлов.
Right. So my story also related to Sergei Smirnov, who I knew from, I think, 72.
Саша тоже будет в космосе.
I just moved to Northwest University, and the first exam I did, you know, to Sergei Manikov, and I was his first student here. And that was the first excellent he gave, and he never gave excellent anymore. It was interminable. And the story that I'm going to talk today also related to Manikov. And that happens in 79, when I discovered this way of reduction of integrable system, which now is known as reduction group. I was so excited, I walked in Chernogolovka and I met Sergei and said that, Sergei, I'm genius. I invented so nice thing that, you know, I'm really proud of it and it really works. And then Manikov immediately ran to Volodya and said, I have concern about Mikhailov's
sanity.
He is walking in Chernogolovka and explained that he's genius. And Volodya said that, okay, take it easy, it's fine, it's okay. We have one more genius in our group. I am genius, you are genius, now we have That was the story. And now what I want to talk about, I did not really well prepared, but I will tell you what happens with this idea about reduction group, how it developed, and some new results which not yet published, and which yields some new equations, differential differences equations, new classes, and what I think about this. So what was the idea? The idea was the following. I that time was not so many integrable systems, but there were a few cases, like just a few, like Sine-Gordon or derivative Schrödinger, quite a few cases. And when I look how people do reduction, I notice that they always use some involutions. Like, assume that Lax operator is self-adjoint or anti-self-adjoint, that is involution, or they just apply some simple involution. And so then I thought maybe it can be extended to a group action. So we have Lax operator. Well, let's, for uniformity, consider always some first order Lax operator, which depends on spectral parameter. And so, and U depends on our variables, etc. So, and what we do transformations. Usually it's kind of G minus 1 L. And here, for instance, minus lambda, or let's put sigma minus 1 of lambda g, where sigma is a fraction of linear transformation and g some matrices. And then we say that, okay, and that will be the same, L of lambda. And this constraint, of course, impose constraints on the coefficients of operator, and that is always consistent with the system. And that is easy to understand, because what we do, we
also convert centrifugations.
If yes, or we can do, for instance, g minus 1 L Hermitian conjugated of sigma, okay, lambda complex conjugated. If we have Hermitian conjugation here, g equal minus L of lambda. That when you want to take into account some reality or Hermitian structure of the operator. So what I did, I say, okay, let's do the following. Let's consider not one transformation, but a group of transformations. And let's consider invariant object with respect to this group. So the group consists of elements G and sigma of lambda, where sigma is a fractional linear transformation, because we are considering now rational lux operators, where dependence in spectral parameter in is rational. If it is elliptical, then you know there is extension to elliptical, and it helped at some moment to solve Riemann-Hilbert problem on torus, because instead of well, I will not talk about it. So the group consists of these two elements, G. And then was a problem. Yes, the group. Now we want to have invariant objects, and we want to have invariant objects, and we want to live with rational functions. That means the group should be finite. And if the group is finite, we are talking about the group acting fractional linear transformations, finite subgroup of this group. And this problem is a classical problem solved by Felix Klein. And the whole list is, of course, a trivial group, Zn, dihedral group, and groups of regular polytops, like tetrahedral, octahedral, icosahedral. So, and that is a complete list of finite subgroups. Klein list of finite subgroups of PSA2. Of fractional linear transformation, which is PSL2. So in a sense, problem was finite to study finite number of groups and how many kind of reduction of this type. Well, of course, it can be extended by these transformations. And in a more abstract setting, we should look on this problem in the following way. We have U is element of Lie algebra, because when we compute equations, we always compute, we do nothing and differentiate. So U is element of Lie algebra. What we do with U, we do automorphism of, so U is element of Lie algebra. We can think that U belongs to our Lie algebra A multiplied on, well, in general, some rational field of rational functions, so some with rational coefficients. And what we do automorphism of this Lie algebra and automorphism of the field of rational functions. So what element of this group, which I called reduction group, is element, so G is a subgroup of group of automorphisms of A C of lambda. Finite subgroup of this group of automorphism, where A is a semi-simple Lie algebra.
Automorphism of algebra?
No, G elements of this, of automorphism of this product.
Oh, the product.
Yeah. In these cases, G is element of automorphism, is, look, the Lie algebra A has
C auto- is a complex plane, yeah?
C of lambda is a rational functions. Field of rational functions on a complex plane. Field of rational functions on the complex plane. And when we did classification, at that moment when I did these things, I was not aware about works of Victor Katz, who classified graded, infinite dimensional graded algebras. But, and that is why probably I was there to consider the group of automorphisms. But the construction, if you think a little bit, and if you read original paper of Victor Katz, which was published in 1968, something like that, he did actually the same with Lie algebra. He considered Lie algebra A, a simple Lie algebra, tensor with, instead of field, he considered only Laurent polynomials in lambda. So
So A of lambda belongs to that. And then he considered the following. He said that let's consider.
So you just consider a set of rational function multiplied to elements of reality.
Yeah, you have rational function in lambda multiplied by element of the algebra. That's how our or any Lax pair looks like.
Yeah. So what did Victor Kass? He considered algebra of that sort. And then he said that let's have a finite order automorphism of finite order of algebra A. Automorphism such that A sub g power n is identity. And then he considered algebra L, which is a set of A of lambda such that G of A of omega lambda equal A of lambda. And that is exactly what is written here. But he did it, he generates a whole group by one element of finite order. And actually if we consider this particular case, that exactly we get here.
Serge, to be more precise, Kass did he did classification of groups of gradient algebras with polynomial growth. The main result was the proof that these algebras have this form.
So in his I read, that is even notation from his paper. I read his paper. He considered this algebra, that was his construction, and then he proved lots of theorems. For instance, this algebra is graded. He showed that this algebra L can be represented as a sum of Ln. And if you commute Ln and Lm, then the result will be in Ln plus M. So it's a graded algebra. So that's what he writing in that particular paper. And what I do is a little bit different. It's included in this case. But even in the even in this case, there is another automorphism obvious. For instance, we can send lambda to 1 over lambda. And this is automorphism of this ring. And we can construct algebra which will have two automorphisms, a group generated by two automorphisms, and this algebra will not be graded. The algebra which will come from here, well, maybe I can give you explicit construction of this algebra. So what you do, you consider, for instance, case 2 by 2, you can SL2, so you consider elements A of lambda. And one automorphism is you send to, for instance, sigma 3 A of, for instance, minus lambda sigma 3. Sigma 3 is 1 minus 1 matrix. And another automorphism, you put A of lambda, send to sigma 1, A1 of lambda, sigma 1. And now you can construct algebra which has subalgebra of this algebra, which is invariant with respect to both of these automorphisms. It will be different algebra. It will be seen as a subalgebra actually of this graded algebra. But if you compute the grading structure of this algebra, you will have that MN AM commutator will belong to AN plus M plus AN plus M plus 1.
Such a differential reduction, which I used in an octagonal system, are included, which I found there in this game.
I did, well, let's, to be precise, I don't want to discuss differential reduction today. because my, you know, I want to stay.
No, it's not differential reduction. It's pure algebraic.
It's pure algebraic. Differential reduction can be done if you replace here by some differential tricks. For instance, examples from Calogero and Gasperis, you know, they.
And the, well, okay, what the reduction which I used for solution on the orthogonal system, is it here or not? Of course, it's not, because it's.
I cannot answer this question at the moment.
Sasha, just one comment. This structure was called in our words with my almost graded structure. What do you have?
Quasi graded, you call.
Sorry?
I certainly you call quasi graded.
Almost.
Yeah. Okay.
Quasi graded.
Quasi graded. They call it quasi graded, and we make reference on the paper. Don't worry about that. don't worry about that.
No, I'm not worried. That's fine.
And actually, but if you go to so and that will be dihedral group in this way. But if you go to tetrahedral, you cannot stay with Laurent polynomials because you will have poles everywhere because the group will carry poles. You can the minimum you will have four poles because four vertices for the tetrahedral and tetrahedral you have a more icosahedral. Well, you know how many vertices you have. It's a minimum or and the maximum for one orbit is 60, 24, 12 poles. So it will be really rational functions. Now when we did the classification of nonlinear Schrödinger type integrable system with Alexei Shabak and Yermilov, we got a long list. And this list contained equations. Most of them were known, but some of them were new. And because the conditions are only necessary, we need some sufficient, and sufficient would define lax representation. And then I really tried to work hard to using walk with the Stabruck method to find these lax representations. It worked in one case and other cases were covered by reduction groups. And what I discovered that one equation in this series was Zn, another Tn, third tetrahedral, and also there was octahedral case, but with including outer automorphism. Icosahedral never appeared. And Lax pairs were in 3x3. In SLC. These outer automorphisms important in the case of more than 2x2, in 3x3 and higher. That is one thing. Then later on, I spoke to Volodya Sokolov and he advised that maybe we should look at this object as a Lie algebra and look how to classify this Lie algebra. And we start this work, and what was shown? That in the case 2x2, so algebra of rank 1, only these algebras give different results. And the invariant with respect to tetrahedral, octahedral, icosahedral will be isomorphic to that. In the case, so we have a trivial Zn and Dn. And actually, it's sufficient to consider Z2 and D2. In 3x3 case, the tetrahedral is irreducible. Is isomorphic to octahedral, isomorphic to icosahedral. And how it was discovered? Because we just compute equations invariant with respect to these algebras, and algebras looks very complicated, lots of structure constants, etc., but quite difficult to establish that they're isomorphic. But equations which appear can be turned one to another by a linear transformation. That was found, you know, the isomorphism. Later on, my graduate student considered 4x4, in this case only octahedral, which is isomorphic to icosahedral, and 5x5 and 6x6, where we have irreducible representations of icosahedral group, and all this equation was computed. In a sense, it's a kind of up to gauge transformation. The list is kind of complete. Now, what we did then? Then there is the following construction. Which I would call Lax-Darboux-Key. So how we get partial differential equations, differential equations, and difference equations? We have Lax operator and Lax pair, or even sequence of this operator, which give us PDEs. That then PDEs, and that one will be equation, the other will be symmetries of this equation. That is well known. Now, we can consider from here, we can consider Darboux transformations. So that is a Lax structure. I like this way. I can write dtn minus an. Okay. It's a Lax structure. Then we can consider where L also. Then we can consider Darboux maps. What are Darboux maps? Darboux maps, that means that we have two linear system, L psi equals zero, and dtn psi minus an psi equals zero, because operators commute, there exists common fundamental solution, psi. And they exist only if and only if they stay commute. So, and then we can consider Darboux maps. What Darboux maps? Is we having psi, we construct a new psi tilde, which is m of, I will not write of lambda usually, and some variable psi, such that m l m minus 1 is l tilde. And obviously, L tilde, psi tilde, is also zero. So we construct a new operator, L tilde, which is different only by different variables, potentials, which now the partial differential equation depends upon. And that is also satisfied these conditions, and same, of course, with all operators. Dtn minus. And also that here psi equals zero. So we map one structure to another structure. So in a sense, we can view this Darboux transformation due to Darboux maps as automorphism of Lax structure. And what we have a one solution of our equation, of our PDE. So that is PDE, Q of U equals zero. We map to another solution. And so L depends on U, lambda and U. L tilde depend on lambda and U tilde. One solution maps to another solution. We can repeat this trick and get a second solution, third solution, etc. And naturally, transformation is invertible, so we map one fundamental solution to another. Why it is a solution? Because, look, they commute before, they will commute after, and they commute if and only if you satisfy equation. So in this case, we construct a sequence un, and for each n, it will be a solution of our partial differential equation. But if we look on the compatibility condition that our dx, for instance, commute with this shift, so that is a shift. We get a simple, let me write what L is. L is dx minus u of lambda. We get the following compatibility condition, that mx minus s of u m plus ms equals zero. And that's what s of u is just application of these shifts. So un is changed to un plus one. And if you look at this system, it's nothing but differential difference system. And all these systems, like total lattice, Ventral lattice, whatever lattice equations, can be viewed in this way, and they can be viewed as a result of compatibility of Darboux, of commutativity of shift and dx. Now, system, our Lax operator may have several Darboux transformations, and we can consider commutativity of Darboux maps. So we from psi we go to psi tilde or psi hat, and psi tilde hat equals psi hat tilde, so-called Bianchi commutativity diagram. And if you express it in terms of m, then you will see that m n s m m m minus m s n m n m m s m n equals zero, and that is nothing but difference equation. But difference equation. So there is a problem now to describe all Darboux maps, and we have a clear connection between partial differential, differential difference, and difference equation. And these Backlund transformations, which I mentioned below, are nothing but symmetries of these discrete equations. Just symmetries of these discrete equations. Okay, but that is a well-known construction, and what we did, we try to extend this reduction construction to Darboux maps and differential difference and difference equations. That's what we did. And on this way, we found a number of new equations. For instance, in SL2 case, there are only five situations. The trivial group, Z2 group, Z2 group, Z2 with some dot, dihedral group, and dihedral, actually D2 is a Z2 by Z2 is a simple case, and Di2 with a dot. So there are only five distinct cases up to the gauge transformations. That case give us nonlinear Schrödinger equation, or which is gauge equivalent to Heisenberg model. The corresponding Darboux transformations, I actually found classification in the dissertation of Seva Adler, when I was his external examiner or opponent, and he found that there are basically two different Darboux maps M and N. One leads to discrete Schrödinger equation, discrete NLS, and another.
Abloy-Sladek.
Huh?
Abloy-Sladek.
No. Abloy-Sladek will be in the other place. And another leads to standard total lattice, to the standard total lattice. And the compatibility of those give us also a couple of discrete equations, one related with DNLS and another with total lattice. That too goes to differential derivative NLS. Derivative NLS, you know what is derivative NLS is. I psi t equals psi xx plus I psi modulus square psi x. Right? With a dot leads to deformation, one axis deformation of Heisenberg. And we complete all these pictures, so I will not write these equations. This equation leads to also equation from our list with Alexei Shabbat and Yamilov I psi modulus square psi x plus plus I probably psi x, I never write it in a complex way. Psi x conjugate.
That's very interesting. Okay. This is going to be.
This is a deformation of that. And that also leads to some deformation.
This is parametric instability.
Deformation of Heisenberg model. Of Heisenberg model. So in SL2, in a sense, picture is complete. There was a paper of Adler and Emilov long ago who also considered this construction, this type of construction for the derivative Schrödinger, but they use in a different gauge, and therefore the result was a little bit simpler than ours.
So you mean that if add to the derivative Schrödinger this term, it's still integrable system?
Yes.
Oh,
well, I know how in real variables it's.
Do you know what's there?
U t equal u two plus I think u square v x plus v x and v t. Minus equal v2 minus v squared ux plus ux. Yeah, I think it is up to some. So in real, that is in a list of our equations with Shabbat and
second derivative should be there.
No, first derivative here, second derivative here.
Second
derivative here. Right. And first derivative here. But it's where we have letter u, here you have letter v. It's not the symmetry.
Do you have any questions?
It's asymmetric. No, it's not asymmetric. They not commute. They don't commute. It's not asymmetric. It's a real deformation. And that
you
is
can it. Write Lux pair for this system. Do you?
Yes. I can write Lux pair. You want?
Very interesting.
I can write you Lux operator for this system. Yeah. Because you will see.
So you have an elliptic operator.
Yeah. No.
No.
No, we have lambda squared minus lambda squared. Ah, just a moment. Just a moment, I have to think. You have lambda squared. The following. Lambda squared minus lambda minus 2. 1 minus 1. Plus 0 lambda u plus 1 over lambda, or maybe minus v lambda v plus 1 over lambda u.
Yeah, something like that.
So it's going from Pavlov.
And that is invariant with respect to sigma 3.
This is an important
A point. Of minus lambda sigma 3 and sigma 1 A of 1 over lambda sigma 1.
That is exactly the example that I say is generalized. The, you know,
if you remove lambda minus 2 and lambda minus 1 term, you get exactly the NLS. But that gives you deformation, the inverse power of lambda.
Right.
And everything consists. And of course we compute all this stuff. But maybe today I will show a little bit, how much time I have?
2 minutes.
2 minutes, okay, then I will not really show, I will... What we did, we went further and studied tetrahedral group and other groups, and maybe tetrahedral is a nice example, and the group is the following. We have A of lambda goes to Q is the omega bar 1 A of omega lambda, and that is minus 1 is at one transformation, and another transformation is matrix 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, and everywhere 2. A of lambda plus 2, lambda minus 1, and here is inverse matrix, and these two transformations...
What is omega? Just
omega cube is 1. Primitive root of unit of cube. So that is of order 3. This transformation is of order 2. So we have g, that is s. We have g cube equal s square equal g s cube equal 1. And that is tetrahedral. Tetrahedral group. So we did with this tetrahedral.
Generators of this group, right?
That is a generators, yes, automorphisms.
And the tetrahedral group, it's 12
elements.
How many elements? 12. 12.
12.
12, yeah.
12 elements.
Yes, it's resolvable, yeah.
12 elements. And we found, of course, equation, but equation we found much earlier, differential with in the paper of Shabbat, with Shabbat, but I probably show you one of equations, just one. Here, quite interesting mathematical problems we solved. One problem is you have two polynomials of many variables. What linear combination can be factorized? That can be solved. And I just draw one equation, difference equation, and then stop, okay? 1 plus s squared u x u equal u vx divided by v, it's a matrix, minus 1 s plus 1, 1 s minus 1, and here you have v minus u, u minus 1 over uv. When you compute, you not always get evolutionary equation. Asset, it's a shift. Shift, operator of shift. So it's shifted. S means U1, S square, U2. So we get this kind of equations.
And UX is?
UX is derivative NX, VX derivative NX. It's differential difference. It's like total, like that. So we have these equations. What is interesting about this equation? That we cannot find any local symmetry. We can construct no local symmetries of these equations, which always have this piece, this operator in front, but there is no local symmetries. That was proven in several models. So I think we should work with differential difference and difference equation. We should rethink this kind of ideology that local symmetries is the in heart of integrability. Maybe we should move to non-local symmetries. There are quite a few examples now which show that we need to develop theory in these directions. That's what we are doing now.
Okay, let us thank the speaker. So, questions, comments, a question?
In case of, if you go to different situations, you take the elements of a group. Are there any examples?
Yes. The whole map is the element of group.
No, but I'm saying just about classification or reduction for different situations. When last operated by itself.
Right. But for in my case, the same. Yeah, right. You're absolutely right. That if you look, no, it's not here. I write this m shifted n equal m shifted n. Mm-hmm. And this m and n are elements of the group. That's true.
Okay, Fima?
У меня вот совсем не по делу вопрос. У тебя вот при разных деформациях Гейзенберг появляется Гейзенберг.
Not in all cases we establish Hamiltonian structure. So there was a paper with Shabbat, a separate shape paper with Shabbat we did long ago, where we studied all integrable deformations of the Heisenberg model, which include Landau-Lifshitz, which include all these things, but these deformations are different.
Okay, so let us thank the speaker again. Now, coffee break.